Do you have a feeling that your cell phone signal is getting worse? From sending text messages to watching videos or posting online, nowadays the connection seems to have more problems than before.
I can confirm that it was better in
the past, because it's not just a feeling and the problem is not just with you. Internet networks in general are experiencing a global crisis. A recent survey in the US showed that out of every 100 times a person tries to use data or make a call, in 11 of those times they encounter a problem. This represents an increase if we compare it to previous years, where the average failure rate was 9 out of every 100 attempts. But this seems like a paradox. If technology is always evolving year after year, why would the quality of service be decreasing? The explanation is closely tied to technology's advancement. It's a problem that has service providers scratching their heads and makes us want to throw our phone out the window when the signal freezes during crucial video moments. And this problem is referred to. It wasn't your signal this time. I will explain the cause of these signal failures. Many things can explain an internet connection problem. In the case of Wi-Fi, it could be a simple power outage, or a modem malfunction, or the fact that you are too far from the router, or even the blinking of the Christmas tree lights. Yes, I was also surprised by the last one. Christmas lights usually lack electrical insulation to be more affordable in terms of cost, and their wires can produce a small electromagnetic field that can interfere with the Wi-Fi signal. And this causes internet connection failures. And it's one of the reasons why the Grinch hates Christmas. Just kidding, he has other reasons. The purpose of this video is to explain the issues with the mobile data network, which is accessed directly from your cell phone on the street. The problem that has caused so many complaints lies in the frequency spectrum used by telecommunications operators. It's a problem that began some time ago. So much so that over a decade ago, the world's largest newspaper, the New York Times, was already warning us about it. But to understand what is happening, first we will need to comprehend what brought us here, the cell phone. The cell phone, which in recent years has become practically an extension of our body, was actually invented much earlier than you imagine. It was created 50 years ago in 1973 by American engineer Martin Cooper. When the cell phone appeared, it was built like a brick. Talking to someone through text during this time would be considered an arm workout. But obviously, initially, he lacked internet access or any comparable resource available today. For a long time, the cell phone was only used to make calls, or, I don't know, play the snake game. But technology for the device has been evolving, the amount of features increasing and the size decreasing, until the smartphone revolution came. It's just that in the past, on computers and cell phones, you had to actively connect to the network. Then you would do what you wanted to do and then disconnect again, returning to your completely offline life. But now, everything changed. We're connected to it always, and that's why these devices already connected to the internet have transformed our way of living in society. The cell phone has become an indispensable item in our personal relationships, studies, and work. It's no wonder that there are about 250 million mobile lines in Brazil. There are more cell phone than people. With many people accessing the internet simultaneously, data traffic is becoming more overloaded. This has been a problem for years, but during the pandemic, the situation has intensified. Many people started studying or working from home, and to add to that, the ease of making video calls and online meetings has led to a stratospheric growth in internet usage. According to experts, data traffic has been doubling every 2 years. But while the number of users has skyrocketed, the structure of telephone companies has not grown at the same rate. A bottleneck currently limits service quality. To clarify, we must examine how a cell phone works in order to explain this restriction. The cell phone is essentially a radio, except instead of only receiving the signal like a typical radio device, it can also emit that signal. When you speak to someone, the microphone captures your voice and converts the sound waves into electrical signals. And these signals, in turn, are converted into digital data, transmitting in radio waves to the transmission towers, which relay this information until it reaches the destination device, where essentially the same process as the first device occurs, but in reverse. The regions of coverage of every tower are referred to as cells, and that's where the name cell phone comes from. Waves between phones and towers travel within a specific frequency. Frequency is the number of oscillations per second for these waves that travel. A 100 Hz wave, for instance, makes 100 oscillations per second, and we can consider the frequency spectrum as an unseen road. It has multiple tracks divided by frequency. For instance, one track for space communications, another for military communications, another for television, another for telephones, and so on. However, within the same tract, like the one reserved for the internet, there still exists a division into higher and lower frequency bands. The higher the frequency, the more difficult it is for it to pass through obstacles like trees, buildings, people. And the lower the frequency, the better the signal can pass through these obstacles. That's why your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network works further than the 5 GHz one, even though the 5 GHz one is faster. Gigahertz is a unit of frequency. 2.4 GHz works at a further lower frequency. 5 works better, closer to the router, and transmits more information per second, but only works closer. This means that there is not necessarily a better or worse option than the other. It's just a matter of different goals. Each telco has its own preferences. One of the main carriers in the US is T-Mobile. In recent years, it has chosen to invest in low and medium frequency bands, which means their signal hardly suffers interference. And that's why it is considered the company with the highest consistency in signal quality. The main competitor, Verizon, has bet on ultra-high frequency bands. This can be good, for example, in a stadium. With a nearby tower, thousands of people in the same location can access the internet quickly. But generally, in daily life, the signal tends to suffer because of everyday barriers. That's why the customers of this company complain the most. In practical terms, each operator buys in a government auction the frequency range it wants to operate in. The highest bidder ensures usage rights. Companies aim for maximum band share to secure a monopoly or an oligopoly, in which a small group controls a sector and seeks to have the largest possible share of bands. And one of the problems this can bring is high prices. After all, with fewer companies in the market offering a service, the more control they have over the prices. And people have no choice but to pay, since it is impossible to live without the internet nowadays. But the biggest challenge currently has been the fact that the available frequencies are overcrowded, which causes all these interferences and signal failures that reach our cell phone. And in order to overcome these problems, companies tend to want to purchase new spectrum bands. Is there a risk the spectrum of frequencies will end? Professor David Reed, one of the creators of the internet, guarantees it won't. He explains that frequencies ending would be like colors ending. After all, an object's color is determined by the wavelength it reflects. He says that the important thing is not simply to increase the spectrum fighting to have a larger band, but rather to make a more efficient use of the frequencies that are available. Returning to our metaphor of the invisible road, instead of building other lanes to transport more vehicles, the best thing would be to make traffic more efficient. One possibility is to invest in public transportation so that the same lane can transport more people simultaneously. In the case of telephone signal, an example of a solution for heavy traffic is the installation of so-called smart antennas. Unlike traditional antennas, which send signals in all directions, this antenna can send waves in the exact direction of the cell phone, and with that, the frequency spectrum ends up being much better utilized. And it is exactly this type of mechanism that is used in the new 5G antennas. 5G, as the name suggests, is the fifth generation of mobile networks. And if you are watching this video on your cell phone, it might even be receiving data through 5G technology. It enables faster connectivity and with lower energy consumption. The issue is that the implementation of 5G encounters a set of challenges. Of the more than 200 million Brazilians, only just over 10 million have access to this network nowadays. The first obstacle is the technological structure itself. Ideally, there should be, on average, one antenna for every 1,000 people. In other words, Brazil would need more than 200,000 5G antennas, which is twice the total number of antennas that already exist from the previous generation in our country. And we still have problems with bureaucracy. Cities need to approve laws to allow the installation of these antennas and the operation of these networks. And this frequently faces political barriers. To add to that, not every mobile device can access the 5G network. Even in some areas where the system is fully operational, many people can't afford to buy a device that utilizes this technology. But gradually, these challenges must be overcome. This is crucial for digital inclusion and societal advancement. New technologies can revolutionize the world we live in. The Internet of Things promises to be the main beneficiary of this new phase of online communication. With it, nearly all objects around us will be connected to the internet. This technology is slowly but surely becoming more and more present in our lives. It is in watches and smart glasses, for example, but in the long run, the potential of the Internet of Things is even greater. With it, luxury products will be more affordable. Your future fridge will detect missing foods and make purchases automatically, revolutionizing the way you shop for groceries. In your residence, the AC, lighting, curtains, and even the locks can be completely automated if desired. In agriculture, irrigation systems will be activated based on temperature and humidity of the air. In urban areas, cars will be fully autonomous and will communicate with each other to organize traffic. Anything you can imagine will be interconnected. It seems that connectivity will be so ingrained in human life that future generations will not even be able to distinguish between what is the real world and what is the virtual world. We will completely shatter this barrier once and for all. The entire world itself will become the internet, and we will become a part of it. Thank you very much, and until we meet again.